in so late, but then every time like, we meet together, I wind up late for everything else for the rest of the day. I thought I might as well just get ahead of the game. To be late to begin with. Well, thank you all for coming down this morning. We've got three foreign policy matters to discuss, and then I'd like to go over the budget situations that now stands. I first want to thank those who worked so hard in support of our plans to help the freedom fighters in Nicaragua. We've made substantial progress in gathering support in Congress for our policies in Central America. And the issue now goes back over to the House after a positive vote in the Senate. I want you all to know that I'll continue to do everything I can to help bring over the remaining votes we need in the House. The tremendous effort that Bob Michael and you and the leadership have made, I'm confident that we can succeed. Now, I'd also like to mention the importance of our proposed arms sale to Saudi Arabia. We have forwarded this notification to Congress, mindful of the concerns that Manny and Hill have expressed. But I think it's very important for us to remember the stake we have in this critical region of the world. The Saudis look to us for help in meeting their defense needs. Recent events in the Iran-Iraq war attach a greater urgency to their requirements. Iran's success of late has emboldened it to take a more aggressive stance vis-a-vis the other Gulf states. And the Saudis and others along the Gulf are looking for a tangible signal that the United States is willing to stand behind them. And now, before calling on George Shultz, I want to mention that we had a lengthy discussion with Ambassador Dobrynin yesterday, and we have agreed to a meeting between George Shultz and Mr. Shevardnadze, and they'll meet next month to further the summit process as begun in Geneva. Now, George.
First of all, on the Contra Hayes vote.
How are you?
Fine, I see. Don,
Jim.
I want to thank you all for being here, coming down to discuss the question of providing assistance to democratic resistance in Nicaragua. They actually turned that another way, freedom fighting. But this is an important national security issue, and I appreciate the help of Jack Munda and Mike Skelton and others who worked with me prior to the last vote to clarify the objectives and the terms of the proposed assistance and to broaden the public understanding of the importance of this issue to our own interests. Some of you, I understand, still retain some reservations about the assistance package, which led to your opposition in the last vote. Since the House vote, as you know, the Senate has approved the assistance package, subject to certain conditions which I previously had agreed to implement under an executive order. But those conditions are now included in the legislation which passed the Senate. They would be used in voting on those as part of the bill. Other events have occurred since the House vote, which I'll ask John and Elliot Abrams to describe in more detail. These events, the invasion of Honduras by Nicaragua and the lack of progress in the latest Contadora effort to move toward a negotiated resolution of the conflict in Central America, underscores the urgent need, I think, for effective support for the democratic resistance there. It's significant that all that I know that how many of us sincerely feel that it would be fine if we could have a negotiated resolution. Well, once again, the Sandinista government that walked out on the Contadora and refused to go along with their proposal. But by providing the support that we can help to ensure against the consolidation, I think, of the communist regime in Nicaragua and against further repression of the Nicaraguan people and subversion and intimidation of its neighbors. I want to assure each of you my continued support for the Contadora objectives. I share the hope of a peaceful negotiated settlement of the conflict in Central America. The assistance which I have proposed is designed to encourage Sandinista participation in a diplomatic resolution of the internal conflict in Nicaragua and of the conflicts with Nicaragua's neighbors. Failure to provide such assistance will only encourage the Sandinista government's intent to eliminate the democratic resistance rather than negotiate, and its continued aggression and subversion against its neighbors. And we just can't allow this to happen when it's within our means to stop it. Now I'm going to ask John Poindexter and Ellie David to go into some detail on the recent events in Central America and on the proposed assistance package, and then we'll have more of a dialogue and less of a monologue.
Thank you, Mr. President. I wanted to cover the national.
Mr. President, good to see you again.
Good to see you. Hi,
James.
Just got married.
Welcome. Nice to see you.
Mr. President, it's a great pleasure.
Good to see you.
Thank you, sir.
Scott, sorry. Nice to meet you.
Hi, how are you?
Fine, thank you.
Good to see you.
Nice to see you.
Hello, Ben Jarrett.
Hello there. Mm-hmm. Nice to see you.
How do you do, Mr. President? Jay Warner.
Yeah.
It's good to see you. Hello,
Mr. President.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Nice to see you.
Hello there. It's a real honor to work for you, sir.
Thank you.
Hey, we meet again. How
yes.
are you?
Hi. How are you?
Thanks. Why not?
Rusty Boucher.
Yes, hello there.
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Hi, sir. Ginny Winnick.
Hello,
nice to meet you.
Good to see you.
Mary Kay, thank you. Good to meet you.
Nice to see you.
So, President.
Nice to see you. Good to see you.
I have a follow-up.
Well, stranger. Hi.
How are you?
Good. Nice to see you. How's it going there?
I'm at Cross North.
All right. Not bad.
You got a fish on? Mark, why don't you get between hurricane and
Rest
the engine behind Connie. Drop your shoulder behind Connie. No, we need to separate Connie and hurricane so we can see Mark.
I think it's a flash of colors there that's causing the blindness.
And if you two guys in the back row there, if you could just for the picture, just kind of go on tiptoes.
I am.
You are? Okay, here we go. Good smile, Jude.
Mark's not smiling.
That's because Duke lost.
One more to go.
Okay, one more. Here we go. Thank you.
You know the importance of interoffice memos and things, and I've got a new pad that I've been using anywhere. My. But I was taught. I was handed one by a very distinguished lady the other day, Sarbuth Lewis. And I'm fascinated by it. Her memo pad.
This note comes from a beautiful rich
woman. Very good.
All right. That's good.
I think everyone ought to have a set of memo pads.
I think so.
That's terrific. I think everyone ought to be
nice.
Like that.
That's
Mr. President, I have one that says we're in big trouble if the Russians ever see this.
I got another one here, too.
No more.
Nice
oh, you know what's from
Mexico?
That's good.
You
can
use
that for the
next
one. That's
a good option.
Well, it's nice to see you all and have a chance to thank all of you for all that you do, although you still don't have the White House Press Corps trained yet.
We're trying.
We're working on that.
Most of them.
I have a follow-up, Mr. President.
Yeah, bring in Gertrude now. Where is she?
What about the bodyguards, Mr. President?
Yeah.
I don't know what that was all about, but I sure was trapped. I couldn't stand and walk away from her.
Mm.
We've got more research on that than you would want to know. Something about this guy's brother is big in the bodybuilding business. The guy that she mentioned has a brother that's big in it. Now, where the award comes in, I don't know. But we've got several news stories that they pull for you on today.
Well, if the cameras weren't here and taking that, I'd go into one of those. Incidentally, do they know, and you didn't hear it from me.
No.
Do any of them know about in China when she managed to get down with us? And, you know that big excavation in China where there are these 800?
Oh, sure.
She got down. Do you know how she got down there? Well, you know, without the hat on, you know, her hairdo is part in the middle and white. And she was trying to get down, and it pressed not good to be bowed down into the Chinese. She's starting this Chinese guard was holding the silver. And Gary Schuster went over to the guard and showed him a dollar bill. And he says, look, this woman's picture is on every dollar bill. And damned if he didn't let her go and she came down.
Honor age, that's right. Well, that's one of those
lovely.
Thank you, sir. This way, please.
Come on.
Lights.
This way.
The next time you see us, we'll have 50 press all around.
Lights.
Thank you. You've got a big
staff. We're worse than the girls.
Thanks, Joe.
Get them out of here.
Well, how do you do?
How do you do, sir? Thank you for seeing me.
Well, listen, it's a great pleasure to see you and be able to thank you for all that you've done for us.
Well, it's very kind of you to say that. You know, I'm still doing it.
Oh, I know.
So I'm going to be with you tomorrow on a pre-brief from Nakasone's visit. And see you in the plane. My wife is still
there. Yes, it's so nice of you to have us.
Hi, John. Wonderful. Thank you.
Yes. This is my daughter, Kathy.
Oh, nice to meet you.
It's great.
Hello. Good to see you.
How are you doing?
Hello. Nice to see you.
Chris, thanks, President.
Chris,
hi, Chris. How are you?
How do we do? How do we do this?
Yeah, we can't look all that serious. You have to smile.
That's right.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. So you don't forget us.
And then you know I'm not doing that.
That's what we talk about.
It's a bookmark.
Oh, thank you so much.
Oh, and a charm in case you.
There you go. Nice. This is terrific, sir. Of course, your time for this.
Thank you, sir. It's wonderful. Nice of you to take the time off.
Well, I'm pleased.
Thank you for taking the time.
It was wonderful.
The better thing in person.
Thank you.
You don't have to.
Thank you.